Hey everyone, today we will talk about how to design a cloud file storage solution. So let's get started. Let's talk about functional requirements quickly. This system should allow users to upload and download files and folders. Users should be able to share files with other users. After updating a file on one device, this file should get synchronized on all other devices. Let's talk about non-functional requirements. This system should be having very low latency. The system should be highly reliable and highly available. The reliability means there should be no data loss or no data corruption. Now, let's look at a very basic design. Let's say there are three devices, out of which two devices are online and one device is offline. All of these devices are subscribing to the same workspace. And let's say at some point of time, all these devices are in sync and are on version 11. Okay. And for this workspace, let's say there's one root directory and there's two subdirectories, one subdirectory having two files and one subdirectory having one file. Okay. So all these three devices are connected to cloud, where there's one service which is primarily responsible for uploading and downloading file, while other service is responsible for syncing the metadata. Here, metadata means the workspace ID, workspace version, all files, IDs, files path, and their checksum mapping primarily. Okay. So this system is very basic system where we are maintaining all the data required. Okay. Now we need to understand that for upward and downward sync between local machine and remote machine, we would have to track the metadata changes on the client side and perform data integrity checks as well. Okay, which means we need to have some client side code to enable the data integrity checks for the sync. So let's say for each device we are having client. Okay, now let's say user tries to perform some operation on a file on device one, and this might be either creating a file, editing, renaming, moving, or deleting a particular file. Okay, what happens next? Very immediately, this client will have to increment the workspace version locally, then would have to upload this file and metadata changes to cloud. Okay, now what cloud will do? Cloud will update the workspace version, okay, based on the client request. Will also update the file content and metadata changes, and will also try to load all metadata for this particular online workspace cache. I mean, online workspace in the local cache, okay, so that all these next subsequent sync can be done quickly using cache itself, and will also notify all devices saying, hey, for this particular workspace, there's a version update available via push notification. And to enable that, this service will primarily publish an event into this particular queue, which can be consumed by push notification service. Okay. Now what happens next? Post receiving a notification on device 2, which is again online but is on the older version, this device will compare the workspace version what it has received. Okay, and if there's a mismatch, which means this device needs to have the downsync from the cloud and will send a specific request to cloud accordingly. Okay. And once cloud accepts the request for downsync, cloud will send updated metadata and block content and the file content as a response, so that client can download specific file ID and update metadata changes locally in the subsequent request. Okay. Now, there is a case where some offline device which are on the same workspace may still want to synchronize, but they cannot receive push notification. What happens for them? All these offline devices may send a sync request to cloud once they come online, and they can follow the same process, and that's how this downsync can be completed on newly available online devices for the same workspace. Okay. Now, we might want to separate out our active workspaces and inactive workspaces file store data to have better performance, right? So this is how we have divided the entire database into two store. One store is having all active workspaces file store, while other is having inactive workspace file store. At some particular point of time, when these inactive workspaces become active, let's say after 3 years or 4 years, we might want to move this data to active workspaces as well. Okay. Now, so far we have done a very good job creating a system design for file storage over cloud. Okay, but there are two challenges. Number one, for all these small changes in the file, uploading and downloading entire file would be highly inefficient, and you might want to know how we can do it efficiently. Okay. Also, how can we ensure the atomic data operations are guaranteed so that there's no data inconsistency? Okay. So all these problems can be solved by using Merkle tree. What is Merkle tree? Merkle tree is primarily a basic tree where we are primarily trying to compute the hash for each data blocks, data chunks, okay, and we want to have hash functions again being calculated on the top of hash for these subsequent blocks to come up as a root hash. Okay, so what it does, Merkle tree allows us to verify the correctness of the data. Okay, that's what Merkle tree does. Okay. And Merkle tree is very useful here because maintaining workspace level Merkle tree will allow us to have, first of all, efficient data transfer, and it also guarantees atomic data operation as well. So now, rather than having a hash for entire file, we might want to divide each file under these subdirectory into some blocks. Okay, and these blocks may grow and shrink independently. At some point of time, let's say block 4 has been changed. Okay. We need not to send entire file. We can just send block 4 and its particular audit trail. Now, what is audit trail? Audit trail is a hash chain from root hash to this particular block 4 path. Okay. So this is how audit trail looks like. Okay. And the good part is searching, insertion, deletion, and update in leaf node in a Merkle tree would require only big O of log n. So this is going to be a performance improvement also. Okay. And for hashing purpose, we might want to use a collision resistant hash function, for example, SHA-256. Okay. So now what we are trying to do, rather having file store, we are having file block store. Okay. And we are maintaining the metadata at particular block level. So we are maintaining block list and Merkle tree for each workspace. Okay. Now let's quickly summarize what we have discussed so far. So there's a client-side code which does the following thing. Number one, break down entire workspace files into blocks. Allow blocks to shrink and grow independently. Track changes in the file content and directory structure. Keep all the file blocks updated and stored separately from the workspace. Compute workspace level Merkle tree and maintaining the block list. Also, check periodically if cloud has any version update available for current workspace. Okay. Now, we want to discuss upsync algorithm, how upsync happens. So, assuming client have updated blocks and Merkle tree with workspace version also being updated locally, and client wants to upsync this data into cloud. How does this happen? Client sends workspace ID, device ID, and workspace version to cloud. Okay, then cloud accepts sync request and provide a upsync ID, because this time the workspace version which client sent was a higher version than that of a cloud one. So cloud understood, it's more of an upsync operation. So client sends, they received upsync ID along with block ID, block content, and MQL tree audit trail for each updated block. And cloud starts receiving this content and updates metadata and block content and verifies the root hash as well using audit trail. Now cloud confirms finally upsync operation completion to the client and publishes the event for push notification service in order to notify other devices for the same workspace, saying, hey, workspace ID, this thing, particular workspace, the version is update is available. Okay. And this is how the upsync works. Okay. Now we also might want to summarize how downsync happens here. So assuming client either have been notified by a push notification or may have checked periodically that higher workspace version is update is available over the cloud, right? So client sends the same thing, workspace ID, device ID, and workspace version to cloud. Now this time cloud understand that the version, workspace version what we have received is primarily a lower one than what cloud is maintaining, so it's a more of a downsync. So cloud accepts sync request and sends back downsync ID along with block ID, block content, and MQL tree audit trail. Okay. For each updated block, now client starts receiving the data, updates block content along with metadata, and finally client verifies root hash using audit trail and confirms the downsync completion to the cloud. This is how we are doing upsync and downsync in the system, and we are maintaining block level information in the cloud. Okay, while client is maintaining both actual files and block level content as well. Okay, so this is how we have designed the entire system so far. Hope you like the video. Please like, share, and subscribe.